So here's a really fast overview of how to set up and shoot really cool paint splash images like the one you just saw in the intro. First, you'll need to wrap the surface of a speaker in plastic. We used a garbage bag. Then you hook it up to a sound source. My paint likes dubstep, so that's what we went with. The trick with this kind of photography is not a fast shutter speed. It's a fast and precise flash. The camera is on bulb, and you can see that the room is completely dark when we're doing the shooting. In our case, we used a laser trigger that sets off the flash when the paint splashes upwards. But you can do the same with some of the cheaper infrared or sound triggers out there. If you have patience, you can just try it over and over without a trigger until you get lucky with the timing. For the paint, we use some washable poster paint mixed with a little bit of water. The trick is not to put a big puddle on the speaker, but little drops with separation in between. We got our speaker at a thrift store and hooked it up to a Mac with a small amp in between. When we play the music, the speaker thumps, the plastic vibrates, and the paint splashes. For the lights, we were lucky enough to have a Broncolor Grafit A4 pack. It has incredibly short flash durations, but you can control the output, you can program delays in, and we were lucky enough to have access to a laser trigger system. You can get some really cool shots like the one you see here, but it does take a lot of practice and it makes a mess. So get ready to spread out some plastic sheeting and get ready to clean things up. Next, we wanted to see what's really happening on top of that speaker. And we just happened to have a high-speed camera lying around, so we decided to shoot that too. This camera is a Phantom Miro EX2. It's the baby brother to the Phantom HD Gold that all that slick slow-motion footage is being shot on in the big movies. This one's capable of 1200 frames per second, but only at 640 by 480 resolution. Strobes don't work for video, so we set up some Lowell tungsten halogen lights and we were good to go. Here's what this looks like shot at 24 frames per second. Here's what it looks like shot at 1245 frames per second.